In this video, we'll go over common Tableau Bridge errors, as well as the best practices for troubleshooting bridge connectivity issues. First, we'll go over common configuration issues, as well as the first steps you should take when troubleshooting a bridge issue. When making the initial connection setup to the data source, you first want to connect locally through Tableau Desktop, and then make sure you publish the data source individually to Tableau Cloud. You will not be able to connect directly through Tableau Cloud to the on-premise data source, as this initial connection needs to be done through Tableau Desktop first. The only exception to this is a virtual connection through your Tableau Cloud site, which requires you to have Tableau Bridge already configured and set up on your Tableau Cloud site. The next best rule of thumb when troubleshooting bridge issues is always ensuring you upgrade Bridge to the latest version when troubleshooting an issue. As Tableau Cloud is always on the latest version, you will always want to upgrade Tableau Bridge to ensure it has the latest maintenance releases and patch fixes. If you're connecting to a private network data source, and the task type on the jobs page is showing as extract refresh slash creation instead of sent to bridge, you will want to ensure that the network type is set to private network on the edit connection option under the connections tab of the data source page. For intermittent refresh issues where the refresh only fails occasionally, you want to make sure that the bridge machine meets the minimum hardware requirements based on our documentation below this video. If the job is being sent to bridge on the jobs page, but the last refresh time is not updating successfully, you can do a local refresh test on desktop installed on the bridge machine to confirm there are no connectivity issues between the bridge machine itself and the database directly. We will be going through a hands-on of most of these steps later in the video, but feel free to skip forward if necessary. Next, we'll go over the most common errors you experience when connecting to flat files through Tableau Bridge. First, you want to ensure that you use the UNC file path when connecting to the flat file on the shared drive through Tableau Desktop. A common error you may see is unable to connect to the file with the file path name if you do not connect using the UNC file path initially. Another common error you may experience if you're using Tableau Bridge custom pools is no pooled agents assigned, where you need to ensure that you have the first portion of the file path added to the private network allow list on the settings bridge page in Tableau Cloud. Third, we will go over on-premise and private network data source connection issues through Tableau Bridge. First, you will want to ensure that the task type on the jobs page of Tableau Cloud is showing as bridge refresh. If you do not see bridge refresh as the task type on the jobs page, you may want to confirm that the data source is successfully published individually to Tableau Cloud and that the network type is set to private network under the edit connection option of the connections tab on the data source page. If you see a no pooled agents assigned error and you are using custom pooling, you may need to add the domain of the data source to the private network allow list on the settings bridge page in Tableau Cloud as well. For general connectivity errors, we recommend inspecting the Tableau Bridge logs, which we'll cover later in the video, or testing with a local refresh on the latest version of Tableau Desktop installed on the Tableau Bridge machine. Lastly, we will go over web data connectors and the common issues you may experience when refreshing these through Tableau Bridge. First, Tableau Bridge only currently supports refreshing WDCs that use basic username and password to connect to the data source. This means that the dialog when connecting in Tableau Desktop will look similar to the screenshot on the right here. Additionally, web data connectors require a custom named pool in Tableau Bridge, along with being added to the private network allow list on the settings bridge page in Tableau Cloud. Next, we'll go through a quick hands-on of how to upgrade Tableau Bridge. First, we will want to stop Tableau Bridge from running. By this, we can select the up arrow down here on the bottom right, right-click Tableau Bridge, and then select Exit. Check the box to Exit Client and Stop Activities, and then select Exit. After ensuring you've stopped Tableau Bridge from running as an application, you can also confirm on the Services tab of Task Manager that the Tableau Bridge service is also stopped. You can then navigate to the latest version of Tableau Bridge using the link below the video to navigate to our Tableau Bridge Releases page, and then install the Bridge Client using the Installation Overview video that is separate from this video. Once you are done downloading and installing Tableau Bridge, you simply need to launch the new client. Enter any credentials prompted for, and then verify that you're on the latest version by opening the client, going to the settings icon here, and selecting About Tableau Bridge. This can confirm if the upgrade was successful. Next, we'll go over a few examples you may see on the jobs page on Tableau Cloud, which is located here on the left navigation taskbar. First, if you see the task type is listed as extract refresh slash creation, but you know it should be pointing to Tableau Bridge with a bridge refresh task type, there are a few things we can check. The first thing we can check is if you navigate to the data source page directly, is on the connections tab here, go ahead and select the actions button here and edit connection. If the network type down here is not selected to private network, you will want to toggle it to private network from Tableau Cloud and then select save here. After you have done this, if you had changed network types, you will want to delete and recreate the schedule in order to kick in the new network type creation. So we'll go ahead and select New Extract Refresh, and then create our daily schedule. And that will kick into effect the new network type selection that we had selected. The other thing you'll want to verify on this page, if you are seeing the extract refresh slash creation task type, is that you see the connected workbooks tab here. This means that the data source is published individually to Tableau Cloud and that you have published it correctly, as opposed to embedded in the workbook, which will not refresh with the bridge refresh task type. So now that we've verified both of those, we can go ahead and do a run now manual refresh here and then navigate to our jobs page to verify that it's sent to bridge successfully. Another common error you may see is the no pooled agents assigned error, similar to this one here, where you will want to ensure that you have added your data source domain or data source server to the private network allow list on the settings bridge tab here. The allow list is down here. If you want a more in-depth coverage of that, I would encourage you to watch the custom bridge pooling video on our Tableau YouTube as well, as that will dive more into that. Next, we will go over when you see that the status was successfully sent to bridge. However, you're noticing on the data source page that the data extract refresh time is not updating successfully. This means that the job is being successfully sent to bridge. However, there's a connectivity issue or an issue with the bridge client itself where it is failing and not successfully pushing back the refresh to Tableau Cloud. First, you'll want to navigate to the My Tableau Bridge Repository folder, which is located in the Documents folder on the bridge machine by default. You will then want to close out of the bridge client completely by right-clicking and then selecting Exit and then selecting Close. You will then want to right-click this Logs folder and select Rename, and then rename it to Logs_Backup. We can go ahead and then launch the new Tableau Bridge client. And then once Tableau Bridge is running again, you're going to notice that it generated a new Logs folder, which will generate a clean log set when we run the refresh and see if it fails. Once you've generated the new clean logs folder, you're going to want to go back to the data source page and perform a run now here. We'll navigate to the jobs page to verify that it was successfully sent to bridge. You can then right-click the logs folder, click send to, and compress zipped folder, and this will be the file that you'll send to tech support if they're requesting bridge logs. If you want to take a look at the logs yourself, you could click on the logs folder here, and I would suggest looking in the latest Tableau Bridge client log, as this will contain most of the connectivity error information. Alternatively to looking in the logs here, you will probably receive an email notification of the failure error message as well. Another good test we can do is downloading a local copy of the data source on Tableau Cloud onto the Tableau Bridge machine and open it in the latest version of Tableau Desktop. You can do this by selecting the three dots up here and selecting download. And then you'll want to open it on the local bridge machine in the latest version of Tableau Desktop. Once you have opened it in Tableau Desktop, you can go ahead and go up to the data tab up here, hover over the data source name, and then select extract, and then refresh, and then select yes. Running that local refresh will tell you if there are any connectivity errors between the bridge machine itself and the database as well. If you have further questions on troubleshooting common Tableau Bridge scenarios or gathering Tableau Bridge logs, please be sure to see the documentation below the video, as well as review our other Tableau Bridge videos on the Tableau YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.